شي ما ابو غبروا روحوا قاديش وحاضلوا شريروا امين. The previous episode we discussed the doctors, psychologists and the sociologists about the yoga's dangers, which is part one. As in this part two, we'll discuss, is there scientific evidence for therapeutic effect of yoga?
As you know, yoga was recently introduced by many hospitals and medical centers as an alternative medicine, especially in palliative care. Even though its effectiveness in treating diseases has not been proven. Indeed, in a study conducted in 2007 by two scholars, Maria Ospina and Kenneth Bond, on the effect of Eastern meditation, like yoga, on health at Alberta University, Canada, they found that there is no definitive scientific proof of any therapeutic effect of meditation regarding diseases such as blood pressure, chronic pain, stress, and the like. Moreover, we have many studies confirming yoga's harms and dangers, talking about psychosis, depersonalization, mania, and other psychiatric complications. On the other hand, yogi are talking about Kundalini awakening effects as natural and temporary symptoms, but in reality, they are mental diseases and satanic possession. Here are some symptoms of Kundalini awakening, as mentioned by yogi. Energetic sensations, such as electricity in the body, a feeling of cold and successive heat, involuntary movements, feelings of euphoria, unjustified and involuntary laughter, crying and screaming, a feeling of insects running down or a serpent along the spine, abnormal mood changes, involuntary body tremors, and also the emergence of supernatural powers. They called it siddhis, such as flying in the air, the yogic flight, divination and precognition. The yogi themselves warn about these and the danger of not to be cuffed and controlled. Professor of psychology Marc-Alain Descamps, a French psychotherapist and professor of yoga for more than 50 years, who visited India more than 10 times, in his book The Kundalini Awakening, published in 2005, indicated the dangers and symptoms of the blossoming of the Kundalini chakra. These are some of the important notes that he made based on investigation of 17 testimonies taken from among 100. First, he said that since the 70s, testimonies about harmful and negative experiences of Kundalini have been increasing and no experience whatsoever like another. He provides 8 criteria to discern Kundalini awakening and its symptoms. The primary criterion is an uncontrolled rise of energy in the back. There are also sounds heard and heat rising from the bottom of the spine, the appearance of light often from the inside, an awakening of sexual arousal, feelings of joy, involuntary movements, the emergence of occult skills or supernatural powers. Obviously, since yoga is an open door to the occult, it's normal to have these symptoms. He mentioned also his teacher, Swami Haruharanda, who taught Kriya Yoga in France and had many of his pupils suffering from brutal rising of Kundalini and asking him for help. As a result of these brutal escalations, side effects are caused by this energy that medicine cannot cure because it is not physical. Awakening does not occur more than once because people often leave the practice. He cites in his book, for example, Jean Hébert, who points to dangers such as heart disorders, spinal cord destruction, sexual disorders, and insanity. He mentioned psychiatrists such as Dr. Kaysen and Dr. Jacques Vigne, who have also written on this topic. And he noticed that people do not necessarily feel all of the symptoms mentioned, but one or two of them. Also, Dr. Sanella Lee, a psychotherapist and ophthalmologist, describes in his book the Kundalini experience, psychosis or transcendence in 1987, 17 cases were diagnosed. He gave information about research centers regarding Kundalini in the world, such as the Kundalini Research Network in the United States. He points to research by Alice Johansson, who experienced an awakening of the Kundalini a year after practicing yoga. He also conducted research in Denmark on 250 cases, of which 76 he conducted a study on them. 42 were not taught by the yoga teacher of the potential dangers. 32 went to a psychiatrist for treatment and considered them psychiatric or schizophrenic patients. And 17 think about suicide.